As you know, we collected the birth dates of some 50 people. And guess what? We don't need 366 people to encounter a collision. Actually, we encountered a collision in a sample of 9 people. So, let us try to simulate this paradox using a program.
Before we get into the details of the program, let me give you a brief introduction of the program for birthday paradox. For birthday paradox, we'll be generating the birth dates randomly. I repeat, we'll be generating the birth dates randomly and we'll not fetch it from the data. We'll only generate the birth dates randomly. So now the question arises, how can we generate birth dates randomly? So birth date will be generated according to the birth month. As you know, some months comprise of 31 days and some months comprise of 30 days. So we have January, March, May, July, August, October and December. They comprise of 31 days. We have April, June, September, November. They comprise of 30 days. So birth date will be generated according to the birth month. As we are generating only birth date, we are not concerned about the birth year. Yes, we are not concerned about the birth year. We'll be only generating the date and the month. That's it. So there is an exception here. As you know, February has 28 days or 29 days. If the given year is a leap year, then February has 29 days, else February has 28 days. So how can we determine that a given year is a leap year or not? So our question becomes that for a leap year, most of the years that can be divided by 4 are leap years. You know this fact. But there is an exception here also. Century years I mean like 500, 600, 1000, 1600, 1700, these are the century years. Century years are not leap years unless they are divided by 400. That means if we have 1700, it is divided by 4, but it is not a leap year because this is a century year, okay? But if we have 1600, it is divided by 400, okay? That means 1600 is a century year as well as leap year. So I repeat, most of the years that can be divided by 4 are leap years, but there is an exception here. Century years are not leap years unless they are divided by 400. Yes, unless they are divided by 400. So now I'll show you the pseudocode of how to determine whether a given year is a leap year or not. So we have, first of all, we'll check if the given year is divisible by 400, then it is definitely a leap year. Else, if it is divisible by 100, then it is not a leap year. I repeat, if it is divisible by 100, then it is not a leap year. Okay. Else, if the year is divisible by 4, then it is a leap year. And rest of the cases, the given year is not a leap year. So we'll go through the pseudocode again. First of all, you have to check whether the year is divisible by 400 or not. If it is divisible by 400, then it is a leap year. Else, if the year is divisible by 100, that means it is not a leap year. Else, if year is divisible by 4, then it is definitely a leap year. Else, for rest of the cases, the given year is not a leap year. So first of all, let me try to code this particular function, this particular thing of how to determine whether the given year is a leap year or not. So let us do that. So I'll just open Anaconda Spider and try to code this. So first of all, let me start with how to determine whether a given year is a leap year or not. So I'll just generate year randomly, or you can also make the user input that particular year. So I'll just generate it randomly. I hope you know the random library. We have already explained it. For example, I take the year from 93 to 2018. Okay. As we are using random, we should import random here too. Next is, we have to write the pseudocode here, not the pseudocode, the proper code according to the pseudocode. So let us do that. I'll use if here. So first of all, I'll say if year percent 4 is equal to 0, okay, and year percent 100 is not equal to 0, then I'll use or here, or year percent 400 is equal to 0. This is according to the pseudocode that I just now explained. I'll repeat it again. Century years, the years that are divisible by 4 are leap years, but there is an exception here. Century years are not leap years unless they are divided by 400. This is the pseudocode that we are using here. So after that, what I'll do is, we have generated the year randomly and we have also written the if condition for the year. If this condition satisfies, that means you have to print given year is a leap year. Okay. Else you have to print given year is not a leap year. So we are done with the program for leap year. So let us try to run it. I'll just write leap.py. Given a year is not a leap year. So let me try to print the value of year also, so that we can get to know that whether the given year is actually leap year or not, or whether our program is working fine or not. So let us check that. 2016, given a year is a leap year. Yes, you can see that 2016 is divisible by 4 and it is also not a century year, so it is a leap year. Let me try to run it again. We have 2018. Yes, 2018 is not a leap year. Again, so let me try to zoom it so that you can also see. Here we have 2005. Yes, the given year is not a leap year. Again, 2003, it is not a leap year again. 2016, yes, this is a leap year. Again, 2011, it is not a leap year. 2001, not a leap year. So this is how we can code the leap year thing. So let us move ahead and try to understand the nitty-gritties of the program for birthday paradox. So now that we are done with the leap year code, I hope you understood that code. So let us move ahead. Okay. Here, what we are trying to do here is, now we have to write a pseudocode to generate the birth dates randomly. Okay. So as I said, different months comprise of different number of days. So we have to take care of all the months and we have to generate the days accordingly. So we have here, if the given month is February and year is a leap year, then we have to generate the day randomly from 1 to 29. If the month is February and the year is a leap year, then we have to generate the day randomly from 1 to 29. If the month is February and the year is not a leap year, then we have to generate the day randomly from 1 to 28. Yes, we have to generate the day randomly from 1 to 28. Then, if the month divides by 2, okay, we have months numbered from 1 to 12, okay, and if it divides by 2, that means, and the month is less than 7, that means the month is either April or June, okay, then we have to generate the day randomly from 1 to 30. January, February, March, April, and June. Okay? So this is it for the month that is less than 7. Now, if the month divides by 2 and the month is greater than 7, what we are referring here, we are referring to the months August, October, and December. Then we have to generate the day randomly from 1 to 31. Okay, now if the month doesn't divide by 2 and it is less than equal to 7, here we are referring to January, March, May or July. These months comprise of 31 days. Yes, these months comprise of 31 days. Now the last condition is left, and that is if the month doesn't divide by 2 and the month is greater than 7, then we have to generate the day randomly from 1 to 30. We are referring September and November here. Please note the fact that we are not checking the condition for February here, since we have checked it at the first place. Since we have checked the condition for February at the first place, we don't need to check it again. So we'll start with February, because February is an exception here. We have either 28 days or 29 days in February. After that, we are done with February, then we can take into account the months that comprise of either 30 days or 31 days. So I repeat here, first of all, you have to check whether the month is February and the given year is a leap year or not. Okay, if the given year is leap year, then you have to generate the day randomly from 1 to 29. Otherwise, you have to generate the day randomly from 1 to 28. After that, you have to take into account the months that comprise of either 30 days or 31 days. If the month is divisible by 2 and it is less than 7, then you have to generate the day randomly from 1 to 30. If the month is divisible by 2 and the month is greater than 7, then you have to generate the day randomly from 1 to 31. If it is not divisible by 2 and it is less than equal to 7, that means we are also referring July here, you have to generate the day randomly from 1 to 31. And the last case, if it is not divisible by 2 and it is greater than 7, then you have to generate the day randomly from 1 to 30. This is how we are going to proceed in the program. You will get to know more about it when we'll write a program about birthday paradox.